marching fireworks. So we're going to start with the fanfare, and we didn't have a chance to rehearse this again. We'll start with the fanfare and the 4-8 cadence, and two times through the fight song with the go cadence, just like we would in pregame. So Grace will start the fanfare, then 4-8, then fight song two times with the go cadence. Then we'll pause and we'll do retro. All right, so we are almost ready to start here. Marching fireworks are simply grateful to be back and doing the things we normally do in a normal season. After last year, having a very revised and strange 2020 season, we're very happy to be back doing those normal things that we've done for years and years. And one of those traditions is our Fairmont pregame show, and we're going to start off with a little bit of that pregame show, starting with our Fairmont fanfare and the fight song. Here we go. Competing We have finished in fifth place with a top five finish, which we've only done a handful of times in the last 20 years. At the Ohio State Buckeye Invitational, the band was second out of 48 bands at the Invitational. The highest score. But even then, we had the fourth highest, I'd like to call it today. I spent a lot of time on spreadsheets today. Out of, I think it was 68 competitions statewide, we got the fourth highest percussion score in the state as far as open air competitions go. And the seventh highest overall band score in all competitions statewide this entire season. We had a fantastic performance in Indianapolis very early in the morning. Oh, I actually had to get up very early. It wasn't an early performance, but 9:30. And by far, our best performance of the year. And the kids just had a fantastic time. And we're very proud of how they did here as well. I have to bring up one thing that we have to do tomorrow. There has been a playoff game on the schedule from the beginning. It's always been there, and there was some issues with busing, and we weren't sure if this was going to happen. Today, we found out the school has rented buses for the football team and the band to attend. To be honest, I was a little disappointed in some of the reactions I got today from some of our students about this trip, and it's a long trip. It's to Toledo. What's the name of the town? Perrysburg! Thank you. Everybody knows where it is. It's 150 miles. So, that was on the schedule, and then we weren't sure it was going to happen, and now the school has gone to great trouble to make it happen. We will make a firm decision by the morning on whether we're going to make that a full band experience or a pep band experience. If we make this an optional pep band, I certainly hope parents and students, but mainly parents, will support a strong show of our students at this game on Friday. I think our community wants us to be there. The school went to a lot of effort to make sure we could get there. And renting buses. If we do make that an optional pep band, we probably will not perform the show or anything like that at this game. It will be more of a pep band type game anyways. But if we make that optional, we will send out a Google form to all of our students first thing tomorrow morning, and we need to have them fill that out during advisory, so we know what to expect as far as attendance, because the bus company is waiting on figuring out exactly how we're going to do that. So we will do that in the morning. Parents, I hope you will talk to your student tonight so we know what to expect when we do that in the morning. So enough about that. Thanks to all of our talented, dedicated students for a great season. It was great to be back and doing all those normal things. Thanks to our staff, Mr. Schick and Mr. Phillips, our guard director, Mr. Earhart, percussion director, Mr. Rome. We had some fantastic experiences for our students this summer. Thank you very much. Thank you to our parents and booster volunteers for your support. We certainly couldn't get on or off the bus or get into uniform without you guys doing all the things you do behind the scenes to make this organization work. Thank you so much, all those parents and booster volunteers. Also, thanks to the Kettering City Schools Administration, Board of Education, Central Office staff, and our principal, Tyler Alexander, for their support of the band program and making sure we have the things we need, including buses to play up. Just thought I'd throw that in. So, without further ado, we are going to perform our competition program. This year was called All Wound Up. Featured some really great music, music that was arranged by Mr. Brown, Andrew Markworth, and our own Mr. Bryce Newton. We're very happy with the way this production turned out, and we're going to turn that over to our drum makers here in a second. I have one more reminder. When we leave, we need to clear everything back out of the arena back to the band room tonight, including uniforms. If I could have everybody take a chair or stand or something with you back to the band room, that will help. If I could have Symphonic Band and Vincent, we make two trips just to make sure we get all the last stuff. That way, many hands, light work, all that stuff, right? Thank you very much for coming tonight, and we'll present our competition show now.
Thank you.
thank you very much for coming tonight. Thanks to all of our performers tonight. Have a great night. Students, make sure you help us clear the arena.